Trending this morning, Earth now has a second moon.
Have you ever wondered about the mysterious mini-moons orbiting Earth? These celestial wanderers might be more than just fleeting visitors. Could they find a permanent home in our skies? Join us as we unravel the secrets of these tiny moons and explore the possibility of them becoming a lasting part of our cosmic neighborhood. What happened? Earth has its very own mini-moon from September 29th until November 25th. The regular moon's new temporary friend was 2024 PT5, an asteroid captured from the Arjuna asteroid group called the Arjunas. This new mini-moon was approximately 10 meters in diameter and was captured by Earth's gravity for 57 days. It was small and faint, so it was not visible to the naked eye or with small telescopes, but it could be seen with larger telescopes. Last month, Earth welcomed a second moon in the form of the tiny asteroid 2024 PT5. Unlike the moon, Earth's primary companion, which has accompanied our planet for around 4 billion years, this new mini moon stuck around for just 2 months before heading back to its home in an asteroid belt trailing our planet and orbiting the sun. A team of scientists, well-versed in the study of so-called mini-moon events, identified the gravitational capture event. They spotted the peculiar dynamic properties of 2024 PT5 as they routinely monitored newly discovered objects for potentially interesting behavior. The object that has paid us a visit belongs to the Arjuna asteroid belt, a secondary asteroid belt made of space rocks that follow orbits very similar to that of Earth at an average distance to the Sun of about 93 million miles, 150 million kilometers. Research lead author and Universidad Complutense de Madrid, Professor Carlos de la Fuentes and Marcos, explained to space.com. He noted that objects in the Arjuna asteroid belt are part of the near-Earth object population of asteroids and comets. Marcos further elaborated that some of these objects in the Arjuna asteroid belt can approach Earth at a close range of around 2.8 million miles, 0.5 million kilometers, and at low velocities of approximately 2,200 miles per hour, 3,540 kilometers per hour. Under these conditions, the geocentric energy of the object may grow negative, and the object may become a temporary moon of Earth. This particular object will undergo this process starting next week and for about 2 months. It will not follow a full orbit around Earth. You may say that if a true satellite is like a customer buying goods inside a store, objects like 2024 PT5 are window shoppers. What is a mini moon? NASA defines moons as naturally formed bodies that orbit planets. Intuitively, we think of moons as big rocks that stick around for a while, like our very own moon. Astronomers have defined mini moons as asteroids or comets that are gravitationally captured by a planet for a temporary amount of time. Small mini moons are very common, but ones big enough to spot are more rare. 2024 PT5 is only the fifth ever detected mini moon captured by Earth. Mini moon events come in two flavors. The first are long episodes during which the asteroid completes one or more revolutions about our planet, with these gravitational engagements lasting one or more years. The second type of episodes are short engagements in which the small body does not complete one full revolution. These temporary captures can last just days, weeks, or even a few months. Marcos says, so far, science has only identified two objects subjected to long capture, 2006 RH120 and 2020 CD3. There are three examples published of short captures, 1991 VG, 2022 NX1, and 2024 PT5. However, there are several others that remain unpublished. Short mini-moon events like this one, in which the small body, in this case, an asteroid, acquires negative geocentric energy for weeks or a few months, are relatively frequent, with several events happening per decade. Long capture episodes, on the other hand, are rare, with Earth experiencing one around every 10 or 20 years. The cause of the ejection of these objects from around Earth is gravitational disturbances caused by the Sun. Once 2024 PT5 has fulfilled its role as a mini-moon, it will return to a sun-centered orbit, remaining part of the Arjuna asteroid belt. Unfortunately, during its occupation around Earth, 2024 PT5 won't be visible to the vast majority of sky watchers. The object is too small and dim for typical amateur telescopes and binoculars. However, the object is well within the brightness range of typical telescopes used by professional astronomers, Marcos said. A telescope with a diameter of at least 30 inches plus a CCD or CMOS detector are needed to observe this object. A 30 inches telescope and a human eye behind it will not be enough. He added that he and his colleagues intend to carry out spectroscopic and photometric observations of 2024 PT5 to better understand its nature. A mini moon is a temporarily captured orbiter if it completes at least one full orbit of the Earth before returning to its usual orbit around the Sun. If a mini moon is captured by Earth's gravity but doesn't make it around for a full orbit, it's a temporarily captured flyby instead. Two of Earth's mini-moons were temporarily captured orbiters, while the other three, including 2024 PT5, fall into the temporarily captured flybys category. Mini-moons are asteroids from the large population of near-Earth objects, or NEOs, that are temporarily grabbed from their orbit around the Sun. Near-Earth objects are defined as natural physical objects floating in space, such as asteroids, space rocks, or comets, dirty space snowballs made of rock and ice, that are orbiting the Sun and approach within 1.3 times Earth's distance from the Sun at some point in their orbit. Because these objects are around the same distance from the Sun as the Earth, they can sometimes be captured by Earth's gravity. 2024 PT5 and a previous mini-moon called 2022 NX1 were both captured from a group of asteroids orbiting the Sun at a similar distance from Earth, called the Arjunas. Arjuna is one of the main characters of the Hindu epic Mahabharata, the first mini-moon and a fake one. The first known mini-moon was called 1991 VG. It arrived in late 1991 and left in early 1992. And like 2024 PT5, it was around 10 meters in diameter. In 2002, amateur astronomer Bill Young found what he thought was a second mini-moon, J002E3. However, on closer inspection, the object displayed a spectrum of light, suggesting it was coated in white paint containing titanium oxide. Then, a study of how the object's brightness changed over time found its shape resembled something like the upper stage of a rock. Astronomers now believe J002E3 is the third stage of the Apollo Saturn V rocket SIVB instead of a natural mini moon. The plot twist of J002E3 made astronomers a bit more cautious. When another mini moon, 2006 RH120, was spotted on September 14th, 2006, it was first classified as artificial. However, after more observations, it turned out to be a natural mini moon, about 2 to 7 meters in diameter. 2006 RH120 stuck around from July 2006 until July 2007. The next mini moon, 2020 CD3, was gravitationally captured by Earth for more than 2 years, making it the longest captured mini moon observed to date. It escaped Earth's orbit in May of 2020. This mini moon was around 1 to 2 meters in diameter. Amateur astronomers Gregors Dushanovich and Jordi Camarasa discovered 2022 NX1 using the Moon-Based South Observatory in Namibia. Similar to 2006 RH120, it was initially thought to be an artificial object from a past space mission. It was later determined to originate from the Arjunas, just like 2024 PT5. While it was discovered in 2022, it was temporarily captured by Earth's gravity in January 1981 and June 2022. It will be captured again in December 2051. 2022 NX1 was later found to be a natural mini-moon 5 to 15 meters in diameter. Will we find more mini-moons? Modeling suggests that, at any given time, Earth has at least one captured mini-moon less than 1 meter in diameter. Even though astronomers think we always have a mini-moon, these bodies are challenging to detect. This is because they are small and faint. They are usually found by projects specifically looking for asteroids near Earth. 2024 PT5 was discovered using the Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System, ATLAS, which is an ongoing project specifically designed to search for asteroids. 2006 RH120 and 2020 CD3 were discovered using the ongoing Catalina Sky Survey, CSS, for near-Earth asteroids. 1991 VG was discovered by the SPACEWATCH group using the Space Watch Telescope. These projects will continue to search for asteroids, including mini-moons. We can also look forward to new discoveries and investigations when the Vera C. Rubin Observatory's Legacy Survey of Space and Time, LSST, starts observing in the next couple of years. This enormous project will take images of the entire sky every few days for a period of 10 years. The first light of the Vera C. Rubin Observatory is expected in mid-2025.